Well, hello everyone, I'm Yanni from BUVU Gaming, and today we are back in Eastshade, and we are just picking up from where we left off last time, out here in the Brushwood Forest, and I'm just trying to see if perhaps we can find something of interest out here, or, well, there is this little puzzle here, but I'm wondering if there's anything else. Where would, might these... drummer people hang out during the night? It could be by the puzzle. Have we seen anything else? There was the tent with the lady who wanted us to catch old pups. But is there anything else out here? Okay. Should still have what we need to craft the tent, so that should be okay, and I hope that should keep us safe. Okay, there's that place over there. We do have those. Because then we could also maybe better time it if we wanted to stay here tomorrow for the eclipse. Not seeing much of anything out here. There's our campsite over there. Right there. Okay, gonna get dark. I have no idea if you can like sleep in the tent or how that works. Might need the coat to wander around here some more during the night. Okay, this is where we came up last time. Then we did kind of wander off in that direction, so I don't think we've actually really followed this path, have we? Not much. I think so. If there's anything of interest over here. Not really seeing anything, no. Oh boy. Oh. But it's getting cold. Okay. That camp. How does this work? How does that work? It didn't seem to have a pop-up or anything. Okay, well, we are gonna end up back at well, Anava, I guess. Or no, this looks like the Kestrel's Eyrie. Actually, I thought the last place we clipped was Anava, but maybe not. No, this is Kestrel's. Yeah. Okay, well, we are gonna go sleep, and then we are gonna head back over to the Brushwood Forest, and I think we're gonna have to wait until we have a... which one is mine? Yeah, that's this one. Until we have a coat, till we can talk to these drummer people, but our tent should still be out there somewhere. I just don't know exactly how it works. Aha, well, it does say here, use a bed or tent to sleep through the night and continue exploring in the warmth of the sun. So we should be able to. It must have a pop-up like that, but maybe I was just on the wrong side of it and didn't make it all the way around before it got too dark. Okay, well, I am gonna head back over there, and then we are gonna continue. Okay, well, I found my way back to the little tent, and it was indeed on this side. It just doesn't have like the same kind of e-pop-up. It has this little circle here, and then you can choose to sleep or pack. So let's just pack. At least we can pick it back up, so we don't have to sit down a new one every time. But I did hear something out here somewhere. It sounded like it came from over here. But maybe they don't have like a recognizable spot or something that they spawn in. So we're just gonna have to come back once it is, once we have a coat. But for right now, I'm thinking, I think this puzzle has to do with, okay, I'm gonna pick you up and bring you over here a little bit. You have you, and where was the other part? You are there, yes. And I still think it has to do with that and this, but it also must have something to do. Let's place you here so we can find you again. And then we have the other one right here. There we go. We're going to need these for something, I don't know. And then I think it has to do with the eclipse, which I think is around midday. I don't know if exactly it's if it's at 12, but you can see it's far from having happened, but it's very early in the morning. Can't even see the sun yet, barely. Wow, look at this view, guys. It is so pretty. But I was thinking while we're waiting, look, there's fish out there. We could try and do a little bit of fishing. But first of all, let's just check up on this. So let's see what it says. When skies return blue and sun shows anew, after skies gone red and cold. That's usually the going red is when the eclipse happens, right? My light I will display, but do not delay, a shudder as air turns gold. Ah. Yeah, so there's going to be a light shining once the skies have gone, after the skies have gone red and cold, but once the air turns gold, I shudder. That sounds like when it's nighttime, I guess. So when the sky is golden, it's just before nighttime. Consider this well and do not object, not once but twice you must reflect, which I think is the two mirrors. Only then can my truth be told. So I don't know if it's this thing that's gonna be lighting. That would make sense. So I think it's, yeah, after the eclipse happens. I'm not exactly sure what time we were here last time, and then we have to use those mirrors. Probably to, I don't know, maybe to hit that thing over there. Well, that was kind of what I was on to last time. I just thought the light would come from there to here. But apparently it's the other way around. Anyway, let's see if we can figure out our fishing rod. So we have a fishing pole. Ooh, we have different types of bait. What is this? Oh, that's a toxic tuba. We have the inky caps and we have... Oh, but we did buy fish of the Fellstream River. Okay, so we have the ultramarine minnow, we have the thunder trout, we have the dry mouth sandfish, and we had the... Oh, nothing. Okay, yeah, but he is a sandfish, of course. That's what she told us, and it also says in here. So, the dry mouth sandfish, it actually looks a little bit like those, doesn't it? It swallows vast quantities of silt, allowing it to rest heavily on a riverbed. Preying on thunder trout, the sandfish emits a burst of sand as prey approaches, disorienting the smaller fish and consuming it along with the displaced sand. So maybe we have to catch the thunder trout, which is like a green one. The mothered trout or thunder trout leaps from water at high speeds before crashing back down. It is believed that the fish do this to catch flies, but it's been surmised that they may also be engaging in play. When entire hoovers of thunder trout do this at once, it creates a rumble that can be felt from land. Oh, so they prey on ultramarine minnows and prefer to live in river waters. Aha. The scales of the ultramarine minnow were once ground to create a deep blue pigment used in paint. These fish consume nearly anything aside from fish and have been eaten, found to eat plants and even eggs. It's a good thing we still have some of our eggs. And we do have the inky caps. So it looks like we have to catch this, then catch this, and then catch this. Right? So blue, green, and the reddish. And it does look like that's the blue there. And then we have the red one over here, but this is not the river. This is more like part of the lake, right? So, it is part of, yeah, the lake. Oh, the little mice updated. Oh, yeah, it's a new day. Okay, but we are getting closer to the eclipse. But that means we have to catch these little blue ones. And then we can go over to the river and try and catch a green one. And then we can try and catch this and see if we can get old pups, right? So, let's see, fishing pole, let's just try to see if we can catch something. Set bait. Ooh. Okay. Left click. Oh. That didn't go very far. Oh, but it felt like they came closer for a second there. Maybe we can throw it out further or something? I don't know. I think we'd have to try and hit it out there. Or are they gonna come? No. What if I just left click? Was that a nibble? If it was, the fish got away. Okay. What if I right click? That doesn't do anything. Okay, what if I... Oh, okay. If you hold down left click, then see, that was a fail. Yep. Okay, so we have to do something like that. Ooh, okay. And then you have to left click. I don't know if it's going to be close enough though, guys. Oh, and we can still move around while we're fishing. I love that. That is cool. They are fairly close to it, but it doesn't seem like we got close enough. Maybe we have to wander into the water a little bit. Or are they going to come? Come on, guys. Oh, oh, oh. See, some of them are a little closer. Come on. No? You don't want it? Hmm. I do love that you can, it's so interactive and that you can actually look around. Well, fishing does require a lot of patience, just checking the sun. Okay, that didn't work. Okay, what if I can wander out into the water a bit? Let's try that again. That's about as far as I can get. Standing here. Oh. Oh, wow, you have to be fast. Huh. Does it use up all my... How many eggs do we have left? We still have 8 eggs. Okay, let's see if we can do one more. So, ooh. Let's try that again. Fishing pole. Yep, that bait. And... Oh, it's too deep. Okay, if we back up a bit. Okay, so just a nibble. How do you know if it's just once it has it for real? It is just a nibble, yeah. Man, it's been a long time since I was fishing in real life. Come on, take it. Oh. Take the bait. Seems like they're just nibbling at the moment. Come on. You're just peeling off the bait, aren't you? Fish can be very sneaky that way, actually. Just kind of nibble off. I've only been fishing with worms before, but... Then they'll just kind of nibble it off and you don't catch a thing. How do I know when it's... Well, the line ought to kind of get along, but so far it seems like they're just nibbling. Oh, come on. It's almost eclipse time. Doesn't seem like anyone really wants to bite. Usually the line would go, you know, out in the water as they try to run away. Not sure how this works. Come on. Nope. Nope, it's just a nibble. Okay, I'm not sure how that works. Let's put you away. There we go. And then we are gonna see how this works. If anything is gonna happen. What time is it? It's 10:48. Hmm. So that fishing didn't work very well yet. Oh, look at this, guys. Oh, I do love the views here. And just look at the water. It looks so realistic. It's so cool. Okay, so what's the deal here? Anything gonna happen? Well, it should happen after the eclipse, right? Hmm. 10:58. Okay, so it seems like it starts at 11, more or less. Shouldn't actually look straight at it, should we? So it more or less starts at 11 and it probably ends at 12 then? Hmm. Okay, well, we are just gonna hang out here and wait and see what happens, guys. So if you're playing this, have you already done this puzzle? I'm kind of happy no one has left any clues to how to do it on in the comment section. And no one said anything about the ziplines. So it's pretty cool to just figure that out. by myself. Yep. Well, I didn't figure much out. Well, I did. I had guessed there was zip lines, so I feel a little proud. But I probably wouldn't have guessed unless it was for that treehouse. Ooh, look at that, guys. So the sky's color is starting to change. Just want to see when something happens. We'll see how long this takes. Otherwise, I'm just going to fast forward a little bit to the point when something happens, hopefully. There we go. The color changes. What time is it? 11:37. Yeah. Okay. Gonna have to try and do some more fishing later and see if I can succeed with it. Because this was going very poorly. Okay, come on. Okay, so now guy has gotten all red. And it is 11:50. So maybe at 12, does it take about 10 minutes? And then it comes out on the other side, maybe? Ooh. Just wait till the sun pops out. Come on. Waiting. Okay, still nothing. 12:04. Okay. Not sure exactly how the sun would hit this, though. Well, of course, the if it's supposed to work like that, the beam had to go from there to over there. So it must come from somewhere on the other side or something. I don't know. Is there anything over here that it could hit? No. I'm not sure how it would hit anything. Okay, now the sun is starting to peek out. Okay. I need one of these. Okay, so we probably have to hit it on this side, right? So, yeah. Okay, so let's see. We are gonna have to go over here and then see if we can get it to reflect it. How do I? That didn't really work. Okay, do we have to go up? Oh, there we go. We got it. We had it. Come on. There we go. We have a light. See? Can we? The question is if we can hit that thing. Okay. Come on. How do you know if you hit it correctly? Not quite right. There. See? See? You hear? Then what?
You finally arrived.
Oh.
Like some tea or maybe some pie.
Well, hello, Mudvillo.
Don't be shy now.
Who are you?
My name is known to all as Mudvillo. My passion is sight and all that it shows. Weaver of light and doctor of eyes. I hold the gift reserved for the wise.
Why do you live underground?
The sun illuminates all I must learn, but a heat so strong leaves me to burn. A dismal greeting from the glorious sphere, so I remain secluded down here. With me lies the gift which everyone seeks. So far, you've all been liars and sneaks, sought out by foe and drunkards unfit. Not one of you has held nearly enough wit. They all bumble in, dreaming of crimes. Every day they show up, it's a waste of my time. But the strings of light you folded and bent prove you've got brains, to some extent. It seems you may just be clever enough, although I'd bet your brain is packed full of fluff. But listen up, painter, for this is your task. Prepare your brushes and hear what I ask. Itself in a constant state of falling, to you it seems that it's always stalling. A stony side where the star hides away, a watchful eye at the peak of midday. When day turns dark, but a moment in time, when a star goes black, though everything's fine, the largest of eyes that stare back at you, a sight that aligns, that's the moment I choose.
Okay, something with an eye. Does it say anything in here? Man. Okay, let's see. Chorus of the night. That was the drummers. Yes, yes, yes. We have to go back and talk to Finn about the mice. Okay, itself in a constant state of falling. To you it seems that it's always stalling. A stony sight when a star hides away, a watchful eye at the peak of midday. Well, that's when the sun is high in the sky, right? A stony sight. Stones, or something with stone. There's like a falling star. To you it seems that it's always stalling, but you'd never see it falling, I guess. Would that be the sun? Because the sun is a star, right? It's like a supernova or something. To you it seems that it's always stalling, a stony side. But, okay. When day turns dark, but a moment in time, when a star goes black, though everything's fine. That would make sense. That's when the eclipse happens. So the sun goes black. It doesn't shine. The largest of eyes that stares back at you, a sight that aligns, that's the moment I choose. Okay, so it has something to do with the eclipse and an eye. Well, there was that kind of thing we found over near the, or further towards the island. There was what do you call that? Like a statue? It's not a statue, but yeah, there was a thing we found. Well, we'll have to go and check that out and see if it has it.
Found the darkness of day, but another piece you've lost on your way. Search the landscape and find me an eye. Give the sky vision, then you'll have your prize.
Okay, yep. It was something with the eclipse. Okay, well, let's see. Is there anything else down here? Oh. Glowstone. Can't pick these up, right? No. Just curious. Oh, you have all these. Oh, this is so cool. I do love that there's a riddle in all this. Haha. Well, do you have anything else to say?
An eclipse you found.
No.
Okay. Darkness of day, but another piece you've lost on your way. Search the landscape and find me an eye.
Search the landscape and find me an eye. Well, it kind of reminds me of a screenshot I took, actually. With this thing that I'm talking about, statue. Well, it's not a statue, it's not the right word for it. Okay, where do we come out? Ooh, Mudwillow's door. Okay, it's over in that direction. See, what time is it? 2:12. But of course, it wouldn't really work right now because we need the eclipse, right? But let's just go and check it out and see if it would make sense. Oh, but this is so cool. We figured that part out. Haha. Nice. Gonna pick you up. Yep. So, let's just go and see. There was way over here. Yeah, it was on the other side of her campsite. Ooh. Take that. Hello again. Take this and this. Nice. Yeah, this thing up here. That kind of makes sense, and it does have like an oval shape, doesn't it? Because I took a screenshot the last time we were here. Aha, look like this. But I guess you have to do it during the eclipse, maybe? Make a painting, not a screenshot. That might make sense, wouldn't it, guys? Then you have to do it. Well, I don't know, during the eclipse? When day turns dark, but a moment in time when a star goes black, though everything's fine, the largest of eyes that stares back at you, a sign that aligns, that's the moment I choose. So it has to be during the eclipse. You have to make a painting out here, probably like this. Doesn't that look like an eye? I think it looks like an eye. Oh. Oh, but that's on the other side of the river. I was about to say, oh, why haven't we been over there? But we can't get over there yet. Okay, well, we kind of... what are we gonna do, guys? Okay, you know, I think I'm gonna bounce around and try and find some resources and kind of spend the night. Do we have anything we can do? Because I really want to see if that's the case, so we can finish off the riddle. So yeah, I think that's it, and then we are gonna... Well, can we already sleep? It's pretty early in the day. But instead of running around, we do have our tents, so we could. And we do have, just checking, we should have a canvas, right? Yes, we do have canvas. We're just gonna have to hope it's the right thing. Okay, let's see if we can do this, actually. Can we pass that much time? Did I not pick the tent back up? Oh, yes, there's the tent. Okay, so let's put you here. And sleep. Ooh, we can. Okay, well, I can pass quite a lot of time, actually. What if we... Yeah, go to... It started at 11, right? So if we say, like, 10:45 or something like that around that time. Rest. Ooh, that's handy. That is very handy. Okay. Yep. So, if we go here, the witch pad is actually moving, I'm thinking. I'm thinking it's a sun pad, so if we just stay here. Let's see. Yeah, something like that. Yep. That should work. Yeah, I think that will work. So, we take this and just kind of wait. Hopefully this is gonna work, guys. Nope, don't want to paint it yet. I'm assuming it has to be when the sky is all red. We are almost there. Okay, come on. Wait till it's completely dark. And there we go. Okay, so let's just try and see if it updates it. Mud Willow's riddle updated. Look at that, yeah. Aha. It's pretty good that I took a screenshot of this last time I was here, otherwise I wouldn't have thought about it. Oh, that's cool. Okay, well, so far so good. Let's take you a pack. Yep. And then we have to find the entrance again. That was way down here somewhere. Not sure what to do with this fishing though, because that didn't really feel like it was working. Maybe you have to click at the exact time when the bubble goes down a little bit. But that's just not how it works when you fish. Like, it doesn't just kind of nibble a little bit. Oh, that's when it acts when it's nibbling. When something actually bites, you can see it and you can feel it. Mm-hmm. So, where was it? It was way over here somewhere. Yep, there we go. Nice. Oh, look at that. There's an eye. Okay, so let's see what she has to say about this. I do love these little poems and riddles. It's so cool. Cave system. This guy's. Isn't it gorgeous? Man. Okay. We are back.
Ah, here is something unexpected. I thought my riddle went neglected. The glowing sun confines me to mud, but this, it puts life in my blood. It's yours, most valuable thing I own, a trade for the clever wit you've shown. This brew's the only one of its kind, and its powers need a solid mind. Drink slow, once a day, your eyes will grow clear. Just a sip, and treasures will glow when you're near.
Sip up, see well, but exercise care. This sight drains your spirit, till none can you spare.
I devote myself to studying eyes, and I've seen plenty brimming with lies. But perhaps you're different in the end. Best wishes to you, my clever friend.
Oh, that was awesome. Okay, can we ask you anything else?
The clever painter back again. Use the tincture well, my friend.
Nope, she doesn't have anything. Okay, well, that probably means it drains our inspiration to use that Mendovian Mud Willow's tincture. One drop a day is all you need to find the items that you seek. Sip up, see well, but exercise care. The sight drains your spirit, so none can you spare. When would I want to find items? And it sounds like you don't really use it up, does it? We're just gonna try. Let's try it. Okay, we still have it. It kind of went dark, didn't it? Okay, well, I'm not seeing anything of interest in here. What if we talk to her?
The clever painter!
Nope. Okay. Well, let's try and head back out. I'm sorry, guys. This is gonna be, like, completely black for you guys. Because the game is very, 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 very dark. There we go. Okay, well, we are gonna try and go back out and see. Oh boy. An interesting light. But yeah, apparently I didn't actually look at my inspiration, but I'm pretty sure it went down a little bit. Oh, so it means that items that we want to find will glow, maybe? I have no idea. Oh, I thought I saw something here. Nope. Oh. Well, it might be relevant later on for something. Because walking around with this on all the time, that doesn't really work, does it? And you can only use it once a day. But it might be a time where we need to find something else, and then it could be relevant to use it. See, this doesn't glow, so... Interesting. Yeah, no, I'm not really seeing anything. Okay, well, what do we have left to do? Oh, we actually still have a canvas. Alright, I bought one. Oh, she didn't even take this. Oh, okay. Well, I think we're gonna hang on to it anyway. So what do we have to do? We have to go back and talk to Finn. Let's do that, actually. And that was over here at Raina's little house here. Aha. And hear about how it went with the mice. Yes. Is he still in the garden? Yes, he is. Hey, little one. Yeah, giving you a little bit of loving, like we were told.
Ahoy there, traveller! Alas, those carrot chompers are still at it. Seems the mice are trapped inside my new fence. Although, they never leave so much as a stem behind. Hungry little creatures, aren't they?
Anything I can do to help?
Why don't you stop by K&K Apothecary? Kai and Kaelin should have some repellent that'll send any critters bolting. They live west of here, along the riverbank on the south side of the Blushwoods.
See you soon! It is the Blushwoods. Why did I think it was the Brushwoods? I don't know. Okay, but we know where K&K Apothecary is. So, what else do we have to do? There's the little mice. We have to talk to them. Wouldn't it be nice if we could do some fishing, though, if we could get that to work. Because then we could do that first, and then we can head over to K&K Apothecary next time. And try and see if we can fish the other fish before going back. And there's still the drumming. The Elixir of Life. Yeah, we have to find all the hot springs. Luck box, top of Nava. Yeah, I think that's the deal. We just need more glowstone so we can get a coat so we can do the drumming part too. Oh, there's so much to do, guys. So much to do. Can I make more paintings? Yes, I could. Okay, let's make one more. Achievement unlocked, carpenter. Nice. Okay, well, now we have 3 empty paintings. That's awesome. Okay, well, we figured out the riddle. That is cool. And, well, we're going to continue this next time. See if we can figure out this fishing thing. And then head over to K&K. So, thank you for watching. And, as always, do take care and happy gaming.